gotcha. I was watching hilarious cat videos of cats being scared by cucumbers. You put it behind them while they're eating or something, and they go berserk as soon as they see it. So, I decided to do it with my cats. That is, until Allie told me that it's actually not very good for them, and you definitely should not purposefully freak out your cats. Apparently, it triggers a stress response, and since you can't explain to your cat afterwards that it was all just a joke, it's, well, it's just not very nice. But why are cats scared of cucumbers? Well, when this whole phenomenon was discovered, there are a few theories floated out there. The one that seemed the most promising was that cats have an innate fear of them. That is, the fear is hardwired into the cat's DNA. It's existed from birth. Wait. So cats are innately afraid of cucumbers? Well, no, not really. They're afraid of the shape of cucumbers because it slightly resembles the shape of a snake. Think about it. If primordial cats encountered snakes, the cats that were scared of snakes would have survived, and those that were not would have, well, I mean, you know. However, this is not true. Cats actually hunt snakes. So what's freaking out our cats? Well, it's probably the fact that there's just a strange object that wasn't there before. Not as cool. But all this talk about cats got me thinking about human flesh bags. Do we have innate fears? Pivot to science. This place is creepy. Scientists have been exploring fear for a long time, and innate fears have been of particular interest because, well, they could give us a glimpse into the lives of our ancient ancestors. Most of our fears, it turns out, are learned. We learn to fear bears and tornadoes and guns and Willem Dafoe, but some fears are innate. You might ask yourself, well, how can we tell the difference? Well, that's easy. You do studies on babies before they've learned what they should be afraid of. Yep, that's right, I'm advising you against scaring your cats, but babies are totally fair game. Until recently, scientists believed that we had two innate fears, the fear of falling and the fear of loud noises. If you've ever taken an intro to psych class, you probably remember the visual cliff experiment. That's essentially where you had babies placed on a flat, checkered surface that butts up against a sheet of glass at the same level. But then the surface falls down a few feet, making it look like a cliff. But the baby can't actually fall off because there's still glass there. When babies were placed on the shallow end and the mother called to them from the deep end, a vast majority of babies crawled to the edge, but went no further. Or they cried because, well, they couldn't reach their mother. Scientists have taken this as evidence that humans are naturally afraid of falling. This place gives me the creeps. Let's get out of here. The same thing goes for loud noises. Think about a time when your cat knocked a glass bowl or something off of a shelf. When a sudden noise is louder than 80 decibels, which is about as loud as a garbage disposal or a blender, it can trigger the acoustic startle reflex. When we're startled by a loud noise, a signal gets sent straight to our brains in less than 10 milliseconds before being sent out to our motor neurons. Allie could always do a video about this startle reflex, so I'm not gonna go into detail about the pathway in the brain, but it's pretty cool. Doesn't matter if you're a baby or a full-grown adult, your brain and body will respond to sudden, loud noises. What's interesting about these innate fears is that they're also shared with most other mammals. They did the visual cliff experiment, for example, with baby chicks, lambs, piglets, kittens, and puppies. All of them found the same results. And if you've ever clapped while your cat was sitting on your lap, you get that same startle response, as well as a few claw marks on your thighs. So those are cool and all, but what if I told you that scientists recently found evidence of another innate fear? Yeah, I told you. So now you know. Okay, so 3 months ago, a group of scientists from the Max Planck Institute for Human Cognitive and Brain Sciences and Uppsala University conducted a study to examine the fear of snakes and spiders. The fear of snakes and spiders are the most reported specific phobias, and the researchers suspected that the spiders and snakes could be ancestral threats. In other words, our ancestors may have been the ones that were smart enough to avoid or kill the spiders and snakes, and therefore lived on to reproduce more. To study this, they brought in 6-month-old babies, sat them in front of a screen, and showed them pictures. Meanwhile, an infrared eye tracker monitored their pupil dilation, which is linked to arousal, aka fear. The images would switch between something innocuous, like a beach ball, to one of our ancestral threats, for example, a bear. The innocuous picture always had similar shape and coloring to the threats picture in order to limit the number of variables that could affect the results. So, for example, a red and black spider would be paired with a red and black flower. A green snake would be paired with a green fish. What the researchers found was that there was no noticeable change for snakes, but there was a significant increase in arousal in response to spiders. What is it about our eight-legged friends that gives us the heebie-jeebies? It's especially interesting because most spiders aren't actually dangerous to humans, but snakes definitely are, especially in Australia. Everything is deadly in Australia. It may just be part of human nature, but more research still needs to be done to confirm these findings and to figure out why spiders are so scary. No matter the reason, it's one step towards understanding our fears and how they came to be. And understanding our fears is really valuable for modern humans because fear and fear responses play a big role in mental illnesses like PTSD and other anxiety disorders. If we can figure out what triggers a fear response, we might be able to figure out how to treat it better in the future. But remember, there's nothing to fear but fear itself. Thanks for watching this episode of Micah Psych. Please don't be afraid to hit that like button, and you should also subscribe. If you want to be the first to know about new uploads, then hit that little bell button in the corner right next to the subscribe button. We'll send you an email every time that we upload. If you really like what we do, check out our Patreon page and consider supporting us. I'm going to upload a video of my cat chirping at some birds. It has nothing to do with fear, but I think it's pretty cute. Until next time, I'm Micah. Ha ha, gotcha.